The talk show is one of television's most enduring and ubiquitous genres.
New episode of Man of the People coming up after the news.
Becoming a culturally significant stage for comedy. Sports.
Watching him, I'm going, yo, he doesn't look like he's running that fast.
Entertainment.
I love the old-fashioned gumdrops on the roof.
And politics.
We're seeing this incredible exit from city council.
So in the 1950s, we were a bit of a pioneer in the talk show genre. Mike Douglas, for example, got his start in television. He was born here in Chicago in the early 1950s, and he hosted a variety of WGN-TV shows.
Mike Douglas and Mike Wallace, who went on to be the face of 60 Minutes, seen here hosting a beauty pageant in Chicago. Both started at WGN. Other Channel 9 talk show hosts included Bishop Fulton Sheen with the Bishop Sheen program.
Love is only the last word at the end of a telegram.
Chicago Tribune war correspondent and book editor Robert Cromie, who hosted Cromie Circle.
Was there really anything going on between Romeo and Juliet, the actor said, in my company there was.
And former WGN news anchor Jim Conway, who hosted a morning talk show.
That's all because buttermilk always makes me very sick, and what's left is about 100 calories.
And then there was a force of nature named Phil Donahue.
It's big and powerful.
He didn't simply have a show. He created a new genre. The daytime TV talk show.
And he's basically the father of the modern talk show.
Donahue started in Dayton, Ohio in the late 1960s, garnering acclaim with a broadcast from the Ohio State Penitentiary.
But that program never really took off until it came here to WGN.
In 1974, he moved the show to Chicago and WGN.
WGN, I think, you know, it launched us.
We had the studio, we had the parking, we had everything available for him.
But when Donahue came here, Donahue kind of put WGN on the map.
The hour-long single-issue program was produced through the facilities of WGN Continental Broadcasting Company and seen live in Chicago on Channel 9 each morning.
From Chicago, you're now in touch with Donahue.
And then on tape on 164 outlets across the country later in the day.
Belina, don't be glum.
Now. It premiered weekdays at 10 in the morning and then moved to 11, preceding Bozo's Circus.
Join us in our grand march.
And it was right in the studio. And, you know, you have live audience. I mean, and then you had the Bozo show, right? You know, going on with a live audience. So there was a lot going on here at the time.
Bringing hundreds of people into the WGN hallway.
So at some points we'd have the Donahue crowd and the Bozo crowd, and you'd see elephants and jugglers and people walking in practicing for the Bozo show.
And by the way, that didn't hurt me at all. We had mothers coming with those kids, and they saw the Donahue audience in the studio. I borrowed off of Bozo. I owe Bozo.
WGN Studio 2 held 200 people for Donahue, and there was a year-long waiting list for tickets.
Phil Donahue was doing his show, and while we were standing in line to get in to see Bozo, Phil Donahue and some big movie star came by, and my mother just had the best experience of her life seeing these big television stars going up and down the hallway in WGN.
There were plenty of stars, just not moons.
Would you do a nude scene?
Yeah, that's my question.
Oh.
No, I think actors should make their living with their heads, not with their rear ends.
The show struck a chord on a national level. It felt real because Donahue didn't read cue cards.
President himself, since both are from the same party, it's not likely that formal announcement will happen now, but at least we can talk about the issues.
Producers did not add canned laughter or applause, which were staples of other types of talk shows. The show was unedited. Donahue was a genial and graying host with Midwestern appeal, who made it hip to be square.
When you talk about reindustrializing America, we can be understood for wondering what that means and what it is that you would bring to the Oval Office.
And he'd run around the studio and jump up on the stage, and he was interviewing people, and it set the stage for future talk shows. He was the first, and it was big.
At the show's height, it was watched by more than 8 million people every day.
He brought in confrontational things, but did it in a classy way.
Name on the back of your magazine?
Donahue and WGN are responsible for two innovations.
Have you ever considered doing a centerfold?
During a break, he noticed members of the audience had sharper questions than he did. Donahue decided to include them.
But often during the commercials, they were asking great questions. During the commercials. One day, I just took a mic and went out in the audience, and it's clear that there would be no Donahue show if I hadn't somehow accidentally brought in the audience.
Ringo,
yeah.
What do you feel was the cause of the breakup of the Beatles?
I've said the reasons were that we'd all, got a lot older. We had families, and we weren't just working for the one goal, which was the Beatles at one time. We all wanted to do different things.
The second innovation was strategic camera placement.
We put the cameras behind the audience, brought the audience up, and made the audience part of the show. And this was at a time when audiences were seldom seen. And when they were seen behind a gel. It was green or red.
It gave the viewer the feel of watching a sporting event and had the effect of forcing the guests to deal directly with the audience instead of playing to the cameras.
I didn't say you shouldn't like me. You're getting crazy. You're all off the subject. You said, I thought you was intelligent.
I'm not getting crazy. I'm not off the subject.
I didn't say
you're
you
saying
should,
throw in our faces that you're black.
I am black.
Yeah. We don't throw our color out at you.
You don't throw your color at me?
Well,
take that white
color.
Jesus off the wall. Take them white angels off the wall. Every time I see Miss America, she's white. I know Miss America ain't pretty some black women I know.
From race relations to women's rights.
Any condition of being a female still may be used against you, no matter what stage you're in.
You are both bisexual.
Yes.
Did you know that when you got married?
No.
Donahue discussed controversial subjects.
We are inside an abortion clinic in Chicago. The patient with her back to the camera is in the first trimester of an unwanted pregnancy.
He devoted shows to abortion and childbirth when both topics were taboo.
Did a birth of a baby show that many stations would not air because they felt it was too controversial. But he stuck to his guns, they did it.
He had the ability to get people to understand complex ideas and emotions and to empathize with guests and even gave them approval to disagree with something they heard.
Donahue said that operating in Chicago, away from the pressures of New York and L.A., gave him more freedom.
There weren't that many other national shows coming from Chicago, and that we would get maybe special attention there. We were so different. We had no desk, we had no couch, we had no announcer, we had no band. We had people sitting on folding chairs. We were visually dull.
Donahue's audience was largely made up of women.
And you like women, and it's a pleasure. And whoever is the woman in your life is very lucky.
Well, thank you very much.
It was said that many viewed him as a sort of stand-in for a husband who actually listens.
You've got to give her that right.
He seemed to gravitate to them in the audience. He'd hold a woman's hand, put the mic in her face, and it seemed to be the catalyst, just the hand holding it.
I mean, this was the birth of the modern feminist movement. The gay movement was gathering steam at this time. Oh, my. And we rode the whole thing. I mean, it was a wonderful ride.
As a host, he melded elements of a news anchor, a therapist, a minister, and a comedian.
You plug in the good old vibrator.
Coaxing humor out of even the most stoic subjects.
How would you imitate John Wayne? Just one line. Just one line.
Well, all right, Pilgrim.
He was equally interested in public policy.
There's nothing worse than an ex-politician who thinks he's important.
Governor, if I were a Republican and decided to run for anything in 1980...
He questioned leaders with an aggressive and unconventional style.
How could you have gone into this campaign, the most grueling experience a man can possibly undertake, knowing you didn't have a shot?
Well, it's probably the greatest honor that I will ever have. To be chosen to be a nominee of my party for president of the United States.
He and his audience interviewed every president from Nixon to Clinton.
I'd like to know what the most difficult decision you made while you were president.
I suspect the most difficult was the
decision to pardon former President Nixon. It was a very tough decision.
You were very successful in the entertainment area. What led you to enter the field of politics?
I'm still asking myself that. I had never intended, I never had any desire to seek public office.
Donahue won 8 Daytime Emmy Awards for Outstanding Talk Show Host, setting the template for all others who would follow, including Geraldo Rivera, Sally Jesse Raphael, Montel Williams, Jerry Springer, and the queen of talk herself, Oprah Winfrey.
The Oprah stuff wouldn't have happened without WGN.
Taking another cue from Donahue, many of those programs were also produced in Chicago.
Because it happened here in Chicago, away from the network hype and the haughtiness and self-importance of the network's way of looking at themselves, I think that gave others here and elsewhere the courage and the ambition to also try to succeed on a national scale.
All that right in this very room we're in
the studio,
right?
Yes.
Now. Man. So Phil Donahue is now 87 years old, and he hosts a podcast with his wife, Marlo Thomas, who you saw in the piece, who actually they met in the WGN cafeteria.
That's right. By the way, next week on WGN at 75, Mike Lowe takes a look at how the WGN News Department has recorded Chicago history one day at a time for 75 years. We're here every day. And we will have special coverage every Thursday night through April on the WGN News at 9. You can read more at WGNTV.com/75.